I'm down at my boat again, just doing some small things here and there to prepare it for the holiday with the kids. And of course, very typical, it's been a sunny day all day, and as soon as you come down to the boat, it starts raining. But anyway, I was down here yesterday, and one of the things I did was cleaning the teak, and I was using something called Snappy. I'm not sure if you get it everywhere. I've used it once before and it's absolutely brilliant, but it's a little bit corrosive. So you have to watch the gel coat and of course your hands when you're working with it. But the result came out very, very nice. The only thing left for me to do is to put some sealer on it. But it should be dry for a couple of days before you do that. Second, I also put in a new battery, which I will show you guys later. And third, I've got a new compass from Silver, because the old one was not very nice and not very readable. There was hardly any spirits left in it or any liquid left in it. So it was jumping all the way around when I was sailing over the in the Skagerrak. So I need a new one. Well, so my boat is a Maxi 87, which is a masthead sloop rigged yacht. And she is, of course, 8.7 long and about 3 meters wide. Well, quite wide for that period of time, during the IOR rule, was the dominant rating rule. She has a fin keel. 1.6 meter draft. The cast iron keel is about 1.3 tons. Well, most of the owners, they have put on a furling genoa, as she originally, with the masthead rig, has a very small mainsail, and they had to hold a lot of head sails from the biggest genoa one and down to the storm jib. And it's not so much space for storing sails in her. That's why most owners have changed to a furling genoa. Well, there's not that many 87s racing anymore, so they're mostly used for cruising. The 87 came more or less in the same edition. They had some extras here and there, but not very big differences. One of the differences was the mast, which could be the black Pelle Pettersson or Briand mast, or you could choose a mast from Selden. I think the Selden masts are a bit better, more lightweight construction, and the mast step is a little bit better as well. One of the other differences is that you could choose to have a tiller or a steering wheel. I'm not sure how many 87s having steering wheel, but I've seen it on quite a few. My guess would be about 30% with steering wheel, 70 with tiller. And also this coach roof hatch was an extra option as well when they were delivered. Up forward here, you will find this forward hatch, and most people of course use it for the anchor and maybe an anchor winch, but originally it was thought as a storage of for the head sail, as the head stay was going straight down where the furler is sitting now. Light is not so good, but so this was actually thought as a storage for sails. It's holding my anchor. I don't have an anchor roller yet, or a bowsprit. So, but that's one of the things I will install for next year. There are different solutions on how you want to guide your cables down on the deck. I've chosen this thing here, so I can pull all the cables to the same spot. But I know that underneath the deck here there's a pipe going, well, it's kind of molded into the deck structure, but there's a pipe going along here and back. So you have the option of pulling the wire in that as well. But my guess is that you will fit two wires up there, not more. And I have like four. This teak in the cockpit was also an extra. And you can actually still have it ordered from Sweden if you want it. It's bloody expensive, but it's a nice addition to the boat. Mine is, or my teak here, is 25 years old. And you can see in one of my videos I was renovating this.
The forward cabin is the biggest one, or it's the only one. Some people have, or some owners have, modified the skylight here with a polycarbonate or plexi, just to be able to look out of it. Underneath the bunk here, you have the there's a storage forward, which is quite deep. And here you have the fresh water tank. And then you have storages on the sides here. And I have on my boat the holding tank for the sewage on this side. And I also have a cushion here, which can, I have like a bracket I can put here with this cushion here. Next, the filming is not so easy here, but next you have a storage here, which is quite deep. And I also have like a closet, and I have also the connection box for my cabin lights here, for those who follow that job. And also I have, it's a bit dark here, but I also have the carbon filter for the sewage vent. And on the other side, you have the toilet and a locker there for toilet stuff. The salon is, in my opinion, very big for a 29-foot sailing boat. I never tried, but I think you can easily sit six people around it. And the good thing about it, well, I never used it, but is that you can lower this table down level with the seats, put a cushion on it, and you have a double bed. I think on most Maxi 87s you have, or you will find, the there's plenty of storage underneath here. There's a locker over there forward. There's one aft here where I keep my tools for the engine and electrical stuff. But on, I think on all Maxi 87s you can find the batteries under here. On my boat, I have a 105 amp starting battery. And this is my new one, which is a 100 amp hour AGM, which was quite an upgrade from our old, from our previous battery, because we only had 75 amp hours normal lead acid. And that outputs maybe 40 amp hours. So an AGM outputs about 80%, so I think we're more or less double the capacity on power. As shown in one of my earlier videos, this is one of the weak spots on the Maxi 87, and I think you will also find the same problem on the smaller models, also the 95.
the 68, 77, 84, 87, and 95. I know the 108 has a different solution here, but I think that from Maxi 68 and up to Maxi 95, you will find the same problem here. I will not go into details on it. It's better to watch one of my earlier videos when I do the repair here. I also chosen to put a hatch here. I'm not sure to call it a hatch, but I have all the cables here from the mast, and I can disconnect them here when I want to take the mast down. The other weakness on the Maxi 87 is the way the rudder is fitted to the skeg. It's a bronze or a brass plating. I do not know exactly if it's if it's bronze or brass, but anyway, this is connected to the lower rudder stock with a bearing, and the plate itself is connected to the skeg with two bolts going through the skeg and into the boat. As the rudder over time starts moving, the problem with this plate is that it's not taking up the sideway movements very good on the rudder. So with time, when this starts to go loose a bit, you have water ingress through the bolts and into the boat. And it took me a long time to figure out where the water was coming into the boat. It took me, I think, the first summer before I figured out it was through the bolt holes. So what I did, I made two new bolts, and I made a stainless steel plate which acts like a washer, and nuts, of course, on top, and plenty of Sikaflex between everything. And in addition to that, I actually fiberglassed the plate to the skeg. One thing you should observe if you take these two bolts out is that the aft one is bent. I thought the aft one was damaged, and I had new one made, straight ones, of course. And of course, I was a bit surprised when I tried to fit it again and it didn't fit. So this bolt actually has to, the aft bolt actually has to be bent to be able to go in. Starboard and port aft, you have two beds, which are, well, I have plenty of space in them, and I'm 175 centimeters long. The bed on starboard is a part of the navigational table, which you can flip up like this. And you can remove this cushion here and this, and you have a nice seat here when you're doing navigation. But I figured out that I have no problem sitting here and doing my navigation, so I normally don't dismantle this stuff. And over here you have, also from one of my earlier videos, this is normally one open shelf all the way here, which I closed in because I put my instruments here, as seen in some of my videos from this winter. The same here. Back here I have made like I'm not sure to call it a bulkhead or bulkhead-ish thing with I had one originally there, but I don't think it came from the factory. So I just made a new one, which I have the regulator for the solar panels. And to hide up all the cables, I made this pockets here in sailcloth. And I actually did the same thing here, just to cover up the instruments. This bed aft on port side also holds the I'm trying to do several things at one time. Here you will find the fuel tank. Sorry, bad light. But the fuel tank is down here. I think that is an original setup. I think on all the Maxi 85, 87s, you will find the switches and the electrical panel here, just underneath the companionway. I do not have the original one, I made a new one, as you can also see in my previous videos. And the stairs is part of the engine hatch. So the engine compartment is down here. The boat came originally with a Volvo Penta MD7. Same on this one. It had an MD7 up to 2002 when this Vitos was put in. But it still has the original sail drive, which is a Volvo Penta S110 sail drive. And seems to be working perfectly. The boat has a tendency, you have some leaks coming from the hatches in the cockpit and stuff, and you have a tendency to get some water back here, and if you don't wipe it up, you know, it will finally end up in the on the floorboards in the saloon. That's not so nice. Well, I hope you enjoyed my little boat tour and the information about the Maxi 87 if you're interested in that kind of boat. I forgot to say that it was produced between 75 and 81, and the production, I think there were about 450 boats produced or built, if you like. There will be more sailing videos coming. I have a lot of fun producing making these videos, so I hope that you can like and subscribe, and I'm very happy to answer comments or questions regarding the boat or the sailing or the area or whatever. At the moment, we're up to the amazing number of 23 subscribers. If you spread the word, it will just make it more fun for me to make the videos. I promise my son will have 100 subscribers by the end of the year. Let's see if I promised him too much or too little. And if you do like what I'm making, you can also follow me on Instagram. You just search up the name of the same name as in the channel, where I will post pictures and videos from sailing, but also from work, when I have something to share from there. In the end, that's why it's called Boating All Around, because if I'm not driving ships, I'm out sailing. So thanks, folks.